I think we got two groups of press coming in, so
we'll
small talk for a minute or two. This bill is represents actual tax increase, and 31% of it represents simply better compliance and collecting money from people who, under the existing laws, owe taxes to the government and are not paying them. And the rest of it happens to be actual reforms that we think are correcting unintended benefits or advantages that have come into being through legislation that here and there permitted an opening for a technically to gain something. But the main purpose of what's going on here in this whole combination is that this combination represents a $380 billion reduction in deficits over 3 years. And 280 of that is in spending outlays, not in this tax package. Incidentally, this tax package wouldn't be the greatest single tax increase if it was all tax increase instead of just 17%. But the thing is, what we're really talking about is the necessity to reduce the deficits and thus get interest rates to continue coming down to get the economy moving again. And this will do it. And those who are opposing it cannot hide from the fact that they are supporting increased deficits and higher interest rates.
Mr. President, on that note, do you think
we'll continue to talk and reason together?
He's not running for president himself.
What?
He's not running for president himself.
I didn't know the job was up to grab.
How does it look now?
I can tell you better after the meeting.